would like to introduce next researcher first, which research about predicting mortality among severe COVID-19 pneumonia patients based on admission vital sign indices from Mr. Piyapat Udompong Phaibun.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Piyapat Udompong Phaibun from Prince of Songkhla University, Faculty of Medicine. Today, I proudly present you about predicting mortality among severe COVID-19 pneumonia patients based on admission vital sign indices. So our background is COVID-19 is remain a major public health concern, which caused 1 to 5% mortality rate. But if patient develops severe pneumonia, the mortality will increase about tenfold. The severity affects the vital sign. And the vital signs are objective measurement of essential physiological function and can be easily obtained. The vital signs are contain temperature, pulse rate, respiratory rate, and blood pressure. And we can integrate it into vital sign indices, such as shock index age, blood pressure age index, mean pulse and pulse max index, as I shown. Previous study revealed that vital sign indices are better predictor of mortality in trauma patients than traditional vital signs. So we hypothesized that this may work with severe COVID-19 pneumonia patients too. Our objective is to describe the association between admission vital sign indices and severe COVID-19 pneumonia in hospital mortality. Let's move to our method. This retrospective study is conducted in COVID-19 ward in Songkhla Hospital between January 2020 to July 2022. Adult patients diagnosed with severe pneumonia from COVID-19 were enrolled. We collect data as vital sign indices at admission, as well as severity score as APACHE-2 and in hospital mortality, and we analyze by regression analysis and ROC analysis. So our result is 502 patients were admitted at COVID ward, and half of them were enrolled with about 28% mortality rate. And after univariate regression, we found that non-survivor has significantly higher heart rate, respiratory rate, SIA and BPMI, and PMI, and lower MP and BPAI. But after adjust with APACHE-2, only SIA were significant with mortality rate. Our ROC curve analysis of SIA indicated that the area under ROC of 0.67 and a cutoff value of 51 for SIA with specificity 80% to predicting mortality rate in severe COVID-19 pneumonia patient. Our discussion, SIA was a mortality prognostic marker in trauma and MI patient. Our study is the first report of SIA in severe COVID-19 pneumonia patient. After vital sign and vital sign indices did not correlate with mortality, such as only half of patients with positive COVID-19 initially present with fever, and systolic blood pressure is affected by inappropriate sympathetic response in advanced age, resulting in false negative shock index and blood pressure age index. And mean pulse and pulse max index use the maximum heart rate, which could be underestimated, especially in the elderly. Our research has some limitations and some room to improve, such as our study is single center study and retrospective study, which may have selection bias and missing data. And the data we use only measure only at one time point. The admission medication treatment such as beta blocker and arrhythmia can cause the change in the vital sign. So we think that we could improve this study by doing prospective study with external validation. For the conclusion, SIA was proved to have a better predictive value than traditional vital sign and could be easily retrieved, calculated, and applied for risk stratification of mortality in severe COVID-19 pneumonia. Patients will require intensive care. Thank you.
Okay, thank you so much for the presentation. We are moving on to the questions and answers session.
Yeah, as you may know that the outcomes of the severe COVID-19 pneumonia depends on many factors. So have you been, have you adjusted, this for the data for, other factors like treatment related factors? For example, the early administration of corticosteroid or, the early ICU admission?
For the assessment with other treatment, we would like to predict the mortality from the admission, so the treatment we will receive after the admission. So to use this SIA to predict mortality from patient admission for resource allocation and prognosis. The factor such as treatment can affect the mortality.
Any more questions?
Yeah, good morning. I think it's a good idea to test the O2 in the novel disease, which is a SIA in COVID-19. But it's good for medical students to try to conduct a research and test with some statistical tests. But if I am a user, I would ask that, can I use Apache to score instead of SIA? Because the odd ratio of Apache to score is a little bit higher. And after you adjust the SIA effect on COVID-19 mortality, with Apache to score, its odd ratio remain only about 1.03, very, very low. What is your opinion?
I think that Apache score can be used, but it is so complex and it requires laboratory value, which sometimes it can be available in some place. So SIA is one choice to use to predict the mortality.
Yes, I agree with your answer. So I think you can discuss that point in your presentation or your publication in the future. I think you try to find a novel and simplify parameters, right? More simple than Apache 2 score. And in my opinion, I think it's not necessary to adjust the SIA by the Apache 2 score because for sure its odd ratio will be weakened. Thank you.
Thank you for your question.
Do I get another question? If there is no more question, then we are taking some time for the scoring process.